In the light of Supreme Court retiring Justice Shri Deepak Gupta in his farewell address, mentioning of a very important and paramount matter that is concerning the entire nation, especially the judiciary, that Article 14 of the Constitution of India, which provides equality before law and equal application, equal treatment of law within the territory of India to all citizens alike without any bias. When equal disbursement of justice and equality before law is a guarantee, is a constitutional guarantee in accordance with the Article 14 of the Constitution of India. The statement that is made by Justice Shri Deepak Gupta in his farewell address, that is as a statement made by the horse's mouth. There cannot be any better authority than Shri Deepak Gupta. So it is a statement from the horse's mouth. Though people like me have been maintaining that there is a violation, willful ignorance, which is resulting in violation of Article 14 of the Constitution by the very makers of the law, that is the legislative, and the custodians of law, that is the judiciary, and those who implement the law, that is the executive. Now, this statement, this popular perception of the common man gains ground as Shri Deepak Gupta, who is the retiring Justice of Supreme Court, that is, this statement is coming from the horse's mouth. He has very clearly, he has mentioned that the law of this nation is inclined towards rich and powerful. That is to say, if the rich and powerful means the backing of political backing with high level influences. So they can purchase the law. Indirectly, it means if a person who has committed a crime, who has committed a criminal act, who has performed an illegal act in the country, and if he is rich and powerful, if he wants to obtain bail, he can move the courts from one court to another court. He has the backing of money, the influence to pull on the case for years and years. He can obtain bail, come out and stay comfortably. And if he wants to quicken the process of justice, he can do so. So this is a serious statement, that is a fact that is expressed concern by the Justice Shri Deepak Gupta in his farewell speech. He has gone ahead further and said that this is the time to introspect. The judges must not hide their heads just like an ostrich. This statement is furthermore consolidates the claim of several advocates and the common man who has experienced the violation, who has seen, who has witnessed the violation of Article 14 by none other than the judicial system and the legislature and the executive. So when Article 14 guarantees equality before law, the piling up of cases of 3 crore 50 lakhs and multiplying number of cases display, bring into the forefront the violation of Article 14. See, the poor people, the middle class, the common man who comes to seek justice, his cases are delayed. And the rich and powerful can alter the case. If they want, they can delay, or if they want, they can even quicken the process of the case. So this attitude, this performance, this system, which is working against Article 14, must go. This is the time to introspect. So the Justice Deepak Gupta's statement should actually be taken seriously by all the three pillars of the democracy, and introspection must begin, without which we will end in a disaster. The system, the democracy, if it is people's democracy, introspection must begin at the legislative, at the executive and at the judiciary. Otherwise, it will be proved beyond any doubt that we have already moved from people's democracy to the capitalist democracy. capitalist democracy is not the capitalist democracy. Our democracy is with the social values.